as we meet in this service of thanksgiving for Yourleen Eudora Bovell, I invite us to sing the first hymn, "Through All the Changing Scenes of Life, in Trouble and in Joy." Kindly be seated. We pray God to quieten our spirits as we prepare to go to Him in prayer. Let us pray. Most gracious God, we turn to You in the sorrow and grief of our bereavement, praying that we may find the strength we need in Your sustaining grace, so that even though we mourn the death of one whom we knew and loved, we may not be overcome by this trial, but we may hold fast, trusting in your goodness and mercy. Assure us, O Lord our God, that death is not the end of those who trust in you. And may our hearts be so composed in the Holy Spirit that all fear and bitterness may be swallowed up in the light and peace you give to your troubled children. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God and eternal God, who by the Holy Spirit minister to us in our weakness, and by the victory of your Son, Jesus Christ, have given us the pledge of eternal life, lift us, we pray, above our present distress and sorrow, and shed the light of your grace and glory upon us, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We are met in this solemn moment to commend Yourleen Eudora Bovell into the hands of the Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Redeemer, by whose stripes we are healed, and in whose name alone we have salvation. Let us then recall to mind the life of our deceased sister through a tribute by Hilda Cumberbatch, and then Mr. Peter Wickham, who is not with us, he's delayed overseas. His tribute will be read to us. So we begin with Hilda.
A pleasant good morning to all. Our friendship started when we were both matured students in the Barbados Community College. We were both mass communication students. Yourleen had a bright smile, pleasant personality, and the trademark wearing her glasses on her head. Yourleen sat in the middle of the class while I sit over to the left. We both ate lunch in the cafeteria every day. Yourleen ate whatever was in my class, whether it was 1, 2, 3, rice and stew, soup, whatever. Yourleen loved pigtails, and I make sure every morning I brought an extra piece for her. Wherever something was happening in Barbados, Yourleen and I went. Yourleen followed me to Crapova, Cadumont, Bridgetown Market, Q in the community, cricket, wherever. Our friendship grew and grew. One day, Yourleen mentioned to me that she had to give up her job in the hotel industry. I said, Yourleen, I will try to be a friend to you. We were from both different backgrounds. Yourleen, her background in the hotel industry while I was in the military. I provided wherever it was possible. After Yourleen left community college, she went to the university. Our friendship continued. One day she told me she met this nice gentleman at university, and I was wondering who this nice gentleman was, because I have been hearing about Elvis from the time I entered community college. She explained it was Peter Wickham, and she was going to go into that field. I said, okay, Yourleen, because her first interest was print. Anyhow, the friendship continued and continued. In 2015, Yourleen introduced me to two of her sisters, Candy and Carol. And it was a good thing that she introduced me to them, because in a matter of 6 months, Yourleen disappeared. I contacted Carol, and Carol got Yourleen, and our friendship continued. Yourleen, despite she being a Jehovah's Witness, she followed me to church at the Cathedral of St. Michael's and All Angels every Wednesday. After service, we went to Cape Shepherd or Shepherd and had lunch. Yourleen loved to read. Yourleen has so many books and magazines, and I'm hoping that they'll be dedicated or given to the church, the library, or a school. Yourleen allowed me to know very early she was diabetic. I had no problem with that, but Yourleen was strong-headed. In 2018, Yourleen came to see me again, and when she came, she was carrying a cane. I asked her what happened. She said she had fallen down, and the glasses were damaged. I said, Yourleen, I'm going to do the right thing. We made an appointment, and she went and got her eyes examined. Our friendship continued. In 2019, Yourleen contacted me again and told me that her mother was not well. Yourleen took her mother death very, very hard. From there, Yourleen's mother was her strength. And 2 weeks after, Elvis contacted me and told me Yourleen was in the hospital. I spoke to Yourleen whenever Elvis went, and it was, her voice was getting lower. One day, Elvis told me she had lost the toe. In 2 weeks' time, she had lost the foot. I personally know Yourleen could not cope with that. And on the 15th of January, my birthday, at 4:42 in the morning, Elvis called me with the news Yourleen had passed away. It took me a while. And last Monday, when Peter Wickham was on the program and he mentioned it, I realized Yourleen has gone. Yourleen was a friend, a confidant. I did everything that was possible. And on behalf of the Mass Comm class, my own family, the instructors, and whoever else, I extend my condolences to Elvis and the Bovell family. May she rest in peace.
This tribute has been written by one of the directors of Cadres, Mr. Peter Wickham, who unfortunately called this morning and said that he was delayed in Dominica, where he had an assignment which he did not plan. He regrets very much that he will not be here, but he pledged that he will come and see the family. The life of our dear friend and colleague and loved one, Yourleen, was tragically cut short. However, at a time like this, it is important to reflect on the contribution she made and the impact that she had on those whom she touched. Her professional engagement was one part of this colorful tapestry that was her life. And I consider myself fortunate to have had an association with Yourleen through her work with Cadres and on a casual basis over the years we worked. Yourleen was easily one of our most colorful associates. And like most of the others, she came to us through her association with the University of the West Indies. She was not in any way a typical book nerd. However, she brought a frankness and a candor to this and every other part of her life. Prior to Yourleen's association with us, we had a policy of not sending ladies to work in some of the rougher areas in Barbados for fear that they might come to some harm. Yourleen single-handedly changed this policy and specifically asked that she be assigned to work in some of these areas as she was more comfortable among the real people and not the bourgeois types. Seeing her interact in this environment was remarkable. She brought her realness to bear on this environment, which facilitated our data collection and what were some of the more challenging assignments that cadres undertook. One of her more recent assignments was the survey of living conditions, where she supervised a small team, and one could not help but be impressed by the way in which she redefined the concept of supervision. She found out what the team members needed, what they needed most to work with effectively, and she sought to provide it, even if it meant that she ended up doing babysitting services. Certainly, we have never before or since had a supervisor who agreed to take care of the interviewer's children while they went into the field to work. But this was the specialness of Yourleen. In preparation for today's remarks, I reviewed our last exchanges, and I'm somewhat ashamed to have realized that she sent me a message in December 2018 via WhatsApp, and I am yet to respond. Sadly, this is a frequent occurrence with me, as the weight of my several commitments oftentimes overwhelms me. On that occasion, Yourleen referenced an article of mine, which was my last as a regular columnist, and signaled my intention to move on to other endeavors. And she said in that WhatsApp, "Peter, pleasant good morning. I just read your column in today's Sunday Sun. Peter, I feel the same way I felt when I got the news that Errol Barrow, David Thompson, and the Dems will no longer be with us. While I'm not thinking morbid thoughts about you, I am thinking that you are saying goodbye to these shores. So before my tears start again, let me say that you are the biggest influence in my life after Jehovah God. So Peter, I wish you all the best. I'm out. I am truly sorry that I never acknowledged receipt of this note or responded, especially as it was prophetic in terms of my leaving Barbados and the challenges faced by the Dems. Sadly, this was the last time we would have had the opportunity to communicate. The note caused me to reflect on the long conversations Yourleen and I had about our love for the Dems and sadness regarding the direction the party took after losing both Barrow and Thompson, and the devastating effect these incidents have had on the DLP. We shared a passion for politics and a love for both Barrow and Thompson. And I feel honored to know that in my own way, I could have inspired her in some way over her short life. On behalf of the other director of cadres, Corey Sandiford, and her numerous colleagues that would have worked with her over the years, I extend sincere condolences to her family and friends here assembled, and hope that at this time you will take comfort from the knowledge that Yourleen's life also touch mine and so many others whom she came in contact with. Thank you.
Blessed be the ties that binds. Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love. The fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above. We stand and we sing this hymn together. Following this, we will turn our attention to the Word of God as we, in humble trust, hear the words of Holy Scripture. Kindly be seated as I invite those who are assigned to read the scriptures to come forward. Sonia Gibson would read Ecclesiastes 3, 1 to 10.
Good morning. Reading from Ecclesiastes 3, 1 to 10. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from from embracing. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. What gain have the workers from these toils? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He hath made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds, yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. Here endeth the lesson.
Thanks be to God. Invite Georgia Innes Bovell to come and to read for us the gospel. This is according to St. Matthew chapter 5, verses 1 to 12. And we invite you to stand for the reading from this gospel.
The reading comes from Matthew chapter 5, verses 1 to 12. When he saw the crowds, he went up on the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he opened his mouth and began teaching them, saying, happy are those conscious of their spiritual need, since the kingdom of the heavens belongs to them. Happy are those who mourn, since they will be comforted. Happy are the mild-tempered, since they will inherit the earth. Happy are those hungering and thirsting for righteousness, since they will be filled. Happy are the merciful, since they will be shown mercy. Happy are the pure in heart, since they will see God. Happy are the peacemakers, since they will be called sons of God. Happy are those who have been persecuted for righteousness' sake, since the kingdom of the heavens belongs to them. Happy are you when people reproach you and persecute you, and lyingly say every wicked thing against you for my sake. Rejoice and be overjoyed, since your reward is great in the heavens. They persecuted the prophets before you.
This is the gospel of Christ. Praise be to Christ, our Lord. We remain standing as we sing together the hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Amen. Kindly be seated. To you, the immediate mourners of Yourleen Eudora Bovell, want to say to you that as a community of faith here at Paynes Bay, we continue to pray for your family as you have experienced the passing of loved ones in recent times. We pray that the God of refuge and strength will be your comforter in this your time of need. To you, Elvis, to Joan, Maureen, Carol, Sheila, Junior, George, Clyde, Jeffrey, invite you to trust in the Lord and not to lean on your own understanding. God will see you through and strengthen each of you according to your need. Let us go to God in prayer. God of refuge and strength, God who in your sovereignty still cares for all your children, we've come to the time, Lord, when we shall reflect and meditate on your word. Be present with us in the power of your Holy Spirit. Open our hearts to receive your word and our minds to understand. And so may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight. For you are our Lord, you are our Redeemer, and you are our friend. Amen. In her 58th year, in the midst of life, as a family, you experienced the passing of your loved one, Yourleen Eudora Bovell. In the midst of life, we are in death is a saying attributed to a source originating in a battle song of the year 912 by Notker the Stammerer, a monk of the Abbey of St. Gall. Certainly, this is a season of life that has brought to the fore the fragility of life. If there's one thing we can affirm, though, is that life and death are in the hands of God. God, who is sovereign, is also a loving and caring God. And so God alone understands the why and the timing in taking those who pass away unto himself. Our breath, our life belongs to God. And as the psalmist reminds us in the 90th psalm, our years come to an end like a sigh. Therefore, we should count our days so that we may gain a wise heart, a heart that seeks the Lord who can be found. In fact, in our experiences of losing our loved ones, regardless of how deep our personal faith in God and his wisdom is, when one faces the sudden passing of a loved one, or even if it is a prolonged illness, as was lived experience of you, the Bovell family, when we take time to reflect on life, we will discover that the Spirit of God within the believer brings us to the place of understanding our own mortality. The writer of Ecclesiastes pens, "For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven." And the first reflection of the writer is one that simply happens to people. That is, there is a time to be born and a time to die. The span between our birth and our dying will always be connected to the one who is the Lord and giver of life. The Lord reveals in Psalm 90 and verse 10, the days of our life are 70 years, or perhaps 80 if we are strong. Yet, Yourleen, who I'm told loved the Lord and was faithful to the Lord, did not make it to the appointed age. What does this say to us other than in the Lord alone is the power to shorten or to prolong our days on this earth? Even so, let us again hear the psalmist speaking a word which can console us. In the 15th verse of the 116th psalm, it states, "Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones." What an assurance this gives to us that God stays close to those who remain faithful, so that even in death, he would have carefully chosen the time to call Yourleen, whom you know to be faithful, into his presence. When we hear the psalmist expressing it this way, it helps you and I to consider that as Yourleen journeyed on that day of her passing, she was transitioning to be with the Lord. And so though she walked through the valley of the shadow of death, she needed not to fear any evil because God, her God, was with her. My friends, mankind is entirely helpless in the presence of death. Death has that final word. But God knows when someone is moving from this world to the next and stays with the believer. And so even as we go through and experience dark valleys in life, according to the experience of the psalmist, there is only one person who can walk with us through the valley and bring us safely on the other side. And that is the God of life. Our God is a God of salvation, and to God the Lord belongs the escape from death. Hence, to us who are alive today, there is a source of strength and a courage to be found in God. Our shepherd offers eternal comfort to those who follow him and trusting in his word is our comfort. He is with us in every situation. When the scenes of life changes, God is with us. He promises never to leave us or to forsake us. And he promises to be our refuge and our strength in times of need. So today, though Yourleen has gone away from us, we can give God thanks for lending her to us. We give God thanks for all of you who share in this service of thanksgiving. And as you mourn, and as you have chosen the Gospel of Matthew, which includes the notion that blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. The Word assures us that mourning is an important response, an appropriate response to the loss of loved ones. And mourning comes to all of us. And the sorrow which flows from our tears, as I know that you have shed tears, cleanses so that you will be comforted. The Lord hears your cries, and he attends unto your prayers and your requests, because he sees all and he knows all. He knows your hearts. He knows your feeling. He knows each of you by name, and he's aware of each need, and he knows how to meet the needs of each one of you and to comfort you and to give you hope. Why can I say that Jesus understands? I can say that with confidence because Jesus was human. And he too went through a period of mourning and the loss of his friend Lazarus. And we know that as he went through that experience, he wept. One writer tells us, it is all right to cry, for it is in our sadness and tears that we express to God that we actually get how good his gifts to us are. God led Yourleen to you. Thank God for his gift and trust him to help you through and to heal you. See, again, we can take example from the psalmist, who constantly reminds us of the praises that he offers to God. Psalm 46 is one such psalm of praise in which he uplifts the sovereignty of God, praising God as protector and having every confidence that God is present in his time of grief and painfulness to deliver him and to set him free. The psalmist also confesses that he is fearless in trusting God, no matter what is unfolding around him. Whatever happens, he is assured that God will help him at the appointed time. He trusts God because he experiences the presence of God, as you are experiencing the presence of God right now. He's here. He's in our midst. And all we need to do is trust him. There's a hymn writer that says, simply trusting every day, trusting through the stormy way, even if our faith is small, trusting Jesus, that is all. Trusting the one who gives us life. The life, the breath we breathe right now. Trusting the one who is our refuge and strength. Trusting the one who, through all the changing scenes of life, his hand is unchangeable. Trusting this God who is present in our midst and in the midst of unexpected circumstances, in the midst of our experiencing distress and sorrow and pain, Jesus, God, is with us. The psalmist placed his confidence in God. And I invite you today to place your confidence in him. You see, God will help us every day that he grants to us the gift of life. He's going to help us. So he expects us, you and me, to be still and to know that he is God. To be still and trust him with our lives. To be still and receive the peace that he is offering to you today. Even in the midst of your trouble, God is offering to you peace. So as we have met to say farewell to Yourleen, as a family, I invite you to let the word of the psalmist renew each of your hearts. Your assurance, your guarantee is that God is, not was, God is your refuge and strength. And because God is your refuge and strength, because God has carried you through these times of anxiety and uncertainty, know that your divine protector will continually be your comfort and shelter and refuge and strength. How do we get that? We get that through relationship. The psalmist had a relationship with God. He communicated with God. He meditated on the word of God. He delighted in God's word. And we can know God for ourselves by spending time with him. That is how and why Yourleen desired to spend time with God. So today, my friends, I invite you, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in Jesus Christ. The one who has prepared a place for the believer whose name is Yourleen Eudora Bovell, who we believe has died in the Lord. So as we close the chapter of her life today, in this Christian service of thanksgiving, we shall commend her to the perfect mercy and wisdom of God. And so for all of us who are left behind, let us be still and know that God is God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Can you stand? Turn with me to page 8 of your order of service. If you believe in this God, the one who gives you life right now, let us affirm our faith in him as we say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost. I believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Kindly be seated for prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Praise be to you, O God, our Father, who created us in your image for eternal fellowship with you. Praise and thanksgiving to you, O Christ, our Lord and our God, who have overcome the sharpness of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers, and are now seated at the right hand of God in the glory of the Father. Praise and blessing be to you, O Holy Spirit, God our Comforter, who bears witness within us of our acceptance with the Father and have become the pledge of our eternal inheritance. All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We bless your name for the life of Yourleen Eudora Bovell, whom we today lay to rest. We give you thanks for the joy and the blessing her life has brought to others, for her service to her generation according to your will, and for every happy remembrance of her life. We bless you for your mercy and goodness which have followed her all the days of her life, that now the trials of this world are over and death itself is past. Receive her into your perfect kingdom and bring us with all who have lived and served you faithfully to the fullness of your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We shall rise and sing together the hymn, "And Can It Be That I Should Gain an Interest in the Savior's Blood? Died he for me who caused his pain, for me who him to death pursued. Amazing love, how can it be that thou, my God, shouldst die for me?"
Thank you.
please remain standing for the commendation, the Lord's Prayer, the benediction. And because this is going to be a cremation, we will commit the body here and then pass it back to the funeral directors until that date of cremation. Eternal God, who have made us all and hate nothing that you have made, and have given your Son for our redemption, we commend our sister Yourleen Eudora to your perfect mercy and wisdom. Eternal rest grant unto her, and let perpetual light shine upon her. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good thing to do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. The committal. We know that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, nor height nor depth nor any other creature can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. We know that if this earthly house of our tabernacle be dissolved, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Since our sister has departed out of this life, and Almighty God in his mercy has taken her to himself, we therefore commit her body to the ground, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all comfort, raise us up, we pray, from death of sin to the new life of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we shall be found acceptable in your sight. This we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Grant to the bereaved consolation and faith in this time of distress and trial, the blessed hope in the coming of your kingdom, the sustaining grace in the fellowship of your people, and steadfastness in the service of your name and the doing of your will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We sing together the hymn, "When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more."
Up yonder, when the road is called up yonder. Okay. Good morning. In the blessed name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We're thanking all of you for coming in the church and on the outside. A special thanks to Mr. D. Hankinson, A. Taylor, another D. Hankinson, and Mr. Steve Mosey. And oh, you're in your slumber sleep. You're always in my memory. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
And be gracious.
Lord.